So usually when I see a movie that has David Spade in it, I'm curious about it. Now, it was only $1, so shit, why not? That is PCU, that is Mr. David right there. And that is Politically Correct University. It has Adam Leff and Zach Penn. Adam Leff is the writer, or at least one of the writers, of Biodome and Last Action Hero. Zach Penn did a lot of the earlier Marvel movies, did the screenplay or the script for Avengers. So, yeah. A great combination. It's directed by a guy by the name of Harry Hart Bochner. We have right here Jeremy Piven, who's been in just tons of things. He's done voiceovers and stuff. We have Jake Busey, who is almost unrecognizable. And then we have Jon Favreau, who has like his short dread-like hair, a lot like Encino Man type of hair. So then it also has Chris Young, who is the one of the sons in The Great Outdoors, the John Candy movie. Buck, that's his name. And so that's really cool because, you know, that's a classic movie. We have the song Pump It Up by Elvis Costello, but it's a cover. It's done, finding out on the special features, it's done by the group Mudhoney. And it sounds really good, though, so don't think it's, you know, disrespectful or whatever. But anyways, Chris Young's character, he. Oh, and then it's got Alex Desart. I don't know exactly how to pronounce his name because it's got a little accent mark. And he's been in a ton of things as well. I know I've seen him in stuff, but I can't remember exactly where I know him from, but he's been in quite a lot. So this movie came out in 1994, so that is 22 years ago, so a long time. And David Spade plays this preppy kind of prick of a guy who's, you know, really full of himself and everything. Jeremy Piven plays a guy by the name of Ross. He's kind of like the Van Wilder, light character. It's not strictly just like sex and stuff like that. It's, you know, partying, having fun, going crazy. So that's cool. But it's called Politically Correct University because what do we know about being politically correct? You know, don't call black people black. You call them African Americans. But if you think about, like, oh, well, what if they're not from Africa? Excuse the yawning. I don't know. Anyways, then they're black people, right? I mean, I have a friend who's black and he's from Germany, so I don't call him black. I call him white. No, but me and him, we're good buddies. He's a ganz toll. Anyways. Let's see here. So that, you know, it's got like the feminists, but in this they're called womenists, and then there's vegans and stuff like that. But the thing is 22 years later, this is how the real world is. Everybody thing is politically correct, but it's worse. So I'm wondering if there's any movies that predetermined, you know, how it would be. I apologize for the yawning. Yeah, so there's some crazy parts. Anyways, we got P-Funk, George Clinton. Yes, the George Clinton is in this fucking movie, which is great. And then a movie with Jeremy Piven, David Spade, Chris Young, also Jessica Walter, who plays the dean, or like the head of the college, who is the voice of Fran, is the mom in Dinosaurs, which is pretty awesome. Yes, the one that's like, I'm the baby, gotta love me. Yeah, that one. Now, what makes this movie so much different, which is fantastic, that aside from the cover of Pump It Up, and I think maybe there's a song or two from Parliament or George Clinton. There is one of the best guitarists, and that is Steve Vai. Yes, the Steve Vai. He does the instrumental music score, and that's what's great about a lot of 90s movies, is you have the instrumental pieces, which aren't just like songs. You know, it's like that 90s feel. You're like, what is this? I like this. It sets the tone perfectly, and it just works so well. Anyways, upon looking at IMDb, some people say, oh, it's a Animal House ripoff or whatever, you know, whatever. I'm happy I invested. I mean, it was a fucking dollar, so otherwise I wouldn't have heard of it. The university they attend is called Port Charles University. So that's what Port Charles University, or it could be politically correct university. So it could be a double entendre. But yeah, a lot like how the movie depicts, you know, there is tons of vegans and these politically correct people, and women especially, womenists especially, when they're getting into our video games and movies and affecting how the creators are like, oh, you know, wait, we can't do that because we're gonna offend them. Fuck that shit, dude. Anyways, it's like they become like the fucking president or some shit, you know, it's ridiculous. Anyways, it's a very fun movie. Steve Vai, you know, it's great. It's great stuff. It's a fun movie. You got this one guy who keeps offending everyone doing this stuff because Jeremy Piven's character, Dross, along with his crew, are telling him, hey, this is what you do. And so they do a lot of stuff to fuck with people. Not per se, like, you know, really dickhead things, but, you know, to say, like, hey, you know, what you're doing is silly or whatever. But they're going to lose their, which is called the pit. And the pit is, they need to raise money for it and figure out a way how to do so. But, you know, it's a fun movie. Great cast. Jeremy Piven. Jon Favreau is crazy. He's wonderful in this. Then Jake Busey. And then Jeremy Piven, he's kind of like a Jim Carrey slash Jack Nicholson mix, I guess. It's kind of hard to explain. Anyways, that is Port Charles University or Politically Correct University. And it's a really fun movie. Great cast. And I mean, Steve Vai doing the score essentially is just fantastic. And then George Clinton, you know, he's one of the big groups that stands out in terms of like just variety, in terms of like the essentially like black musical group or band. I mean, right, you know, and Fishbone is not very far behind because they're just They totally do their own thing, and they're really just incredibly unique. Anyways, George Clinton, Parliament, just fucking epic, dude. And then Steve Vai, I mean, you know, the song Pump It Up totally fits the thing, the mood of the movie. It's just a great, fun movie. And it's got some bonus features, too. A music video for Pump It Up, some behind the scenes. And it's good. So it's a pretty simple case, but it's very fun. And Chris Young is... he is just a blast. Just, wow. He is a fun, super fun character. And... the movie goes by pretty quick, but it doesn't have, like, any slow parts or whatever. It just flows. Like, I didn't really even need to take a break, you know? I just watched it. It was great. Anyways, PCU review, and yeah, shoot.